السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما نافعا والحقنا بعبادك الصالحين. آمين آمين. This is lecture number 6 or part 6 of our series on the history of Palestine, and inshallah today we will continue from the end of Sulaiman alayhi salam, or the end of his rule. Sulaiman alayhi salam and Dawood alayhi salam ruled for 80 years, and they ruled, like we said, almost three quarters of this land of Palestine, and not even the whole land. After the demise of Sulaiman alayhi salam, like we mentioned yesterday, that Bani Israel always, throughout time, from before, from Musa alayhi salam, which they did not give a single day's break to. After that, Harun alayhi salam, Yusha' bin Nun, all the prophets that came, prophets we know and prophets we don't know. We know that Bani Israel always transgressed and disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his prophets. However, for the period of Dawood alayhi salam and Sulaiman alayhi salam, 40 years in the time of Dawood alayhi salam and 40 years in the period of Sulaiman alayhi salam, from 1004 BC till 923 BC, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon these two prophets power and might that they controlled, and Bani Israel could not defy them and cause mischief in the earth. And this is the only period of time throughout all the years that Bani Israel were in Palestine, in this land, throughout all these years. This is the only time, 80 years, where we see that Bani Israel and this land here is a witness to the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Sulaiman alayhi salam passes away in the year 923 BC, and immediately after his passing, Bani Israel resurge and they return to what they were used to do with the other prophets. They return to their old ways. Immediately they begin to quarrel and fight upon between themselves, and they split up into two groups. Now we said that the children of Ya'qub alayhi salam, who are Bani Israel of Israel, were 12 tribes. These 12 tribes now began to quarrel and fight, and they split up into two parts. 10 tribes split up into one part, and they settle in the north of Palestine, which they call thereafter the Kingdom of Israel, and that's where they established themselves. The remainder two tribes, from the children of Binyamin and Yehuda, set up in the south of Palestine, and they call this kingdom of theirs Judea. And immediately they began now transgressing like they did before. In the time of Sulaiman alayhi salam, the lands he ruled were free from idol worship, free from polytheism. All these lands were on Tawheed. So they went out then to the lands of the Canaanites and the Jebusites and took from what they left behind in the from the idols in Syria, in Lebanon, in Jordan, in all these areas that were not controlled by Sulaiman alayhi salam, and brought the idols back to Palestine, where they immediately began idol worship and polytheism once again. Both in the kingdom of Israel and in the kingdom of Judea, this was their way. And immediately they began in their mischief in the land, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left them for a time. The kingdom of Israel in the north, where these 10 tribes were, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left them for 202 years until he sent upon them the Assyrians from the north of Al-Iraq, and they came and conquered them and plundered the entire place. They didn't leave any city or any village, any monument. They left nothing. Even the men, women, and children were taken as slaves and then sold throughout the known world at that time. And this marks the end of these 10 tribes. No remnants of them remain in the world, nowhere to be seen. They were sold into slavery or killed. What they left behind for those 202 years up until 721 BC, from the demise of Dawood alayhi salam in 923 till 721, all of it was destroyed. And like we said, no remnants of them remain. There are no people that can claim that they are from these 10 tribes in today's times, and even in times closer to their fall in 721. So the Assyrians came and they took over and they sold them into slavery, every last one of them. Their brethren in the south did not take note of this. They did not take lesson for this, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let them transgress for 150 years after that. and they remained for 150 years after the fall of their brethren in 721 BC, transgressing and killing their prophets and breaking their covenants with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and so on and so forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا نَقْضِيهِمْ مِيثَاقَهُمْ وَكُفْرِهِمْ بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَقَتْلِهِمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ. Allah says, and we curse them for breaking the covenants and disbelieving in the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sign after sign, like we mentioned before, in the time of Musa alayhi salam, the miracles they saw, in the time of Yusha, and so on and so forth, up until the present point. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says sign after sign, and they disbelieved. وَقَتْلِهِمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ, and they killed the messengers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we curse them for this. 150 years pass, and in the year 596 BC, the Babylonians come in with an army and plunder through the land, and they take 10,000 men from Judea, and these 10,000 men or 10,000 people are then sold into slavery as well, and plunder happened, killing happened. They lost a lot of lives, they lost a lot of wealth, income, the economy, everything was destroyed or almost destroyed. But this was just a sign. Not all of them were taken, not all of them were killed. Not everything was lost. This was a sign for them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but yet they did not turn back and they did not change their ways. They continued in their transgression and disbelief. And it is from these people in Judea, the children of Binyamin and Yehuda, they took Yehuda as their leader, or they followed Yehuda, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala generally sent leaders from this lineage of Yehuda. And from this name Yehuda, did they name Yehud come? The Jews came and the name was decided from Yehuda, or Judaism was taken from the lineage of this son of Yaqub alayhi salam, or rather the name was taken from his name. 11 years pass and they continue to transgress. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends upon them Nebuchadnezzar from Babylon. And he comes with a strong army, mighty and powerful, sweeps through the lands, and all of them, those who managed to survive and escape to Egypt, but the remainder of them, 40,000, were taken and subjugated in Babylonia after that, and made to work under the Babylonians like they did before under the Egyptians. This was in the year 586 BC, and this marks the ending of Judaism, or the children of Israel, Bani Israel, in Palestine. No remnants were left behind. No people were left behind. The land was cleared from them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in the Quran, speaks about this event in the Quran, and he speaks about their reward for what they had done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَقَضَيْنَا إِلَى بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ فِي الْكِتَابِ لَتُفْسِدُنَّ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَّتَيْنِ وَلَتَعْلُنَّ عُلُوًا كَبِيرًا. And we conveyed to the children of Israel in the scripture, you will surely cause corruption on earth twice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they will cause corruption on earth twice. And you will surely reach great haughtiness. The commentators of this ayah mention that the first corruption that was caused on earth was after the demise of Sulaiman alayhi salam in 923 BC. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala left them to their own devices, and they caused corruption and mischief on earth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them his servants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the ayah after that, فَإِذَا جَاءَ وَعْدُ أُولَاهُمَا. And if the promise of the first corruption comes after they have spread mischief on earth and they were corrupt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now his promise has come. بَعَثْنَا عَلَيْكُمْ, we send upon you all, عِبَادًا لَنَا, servants of ours, أُولِي بَأْسٍ شَدِيدٍ, mighty and powerful in military strength. فَجَاسُوا خِلَالَ الدِّيَارِ وَكَانَ وَعْدًا مَفْعُولًا. So they entered the lands and probed the houses. They didn't leave any place untouched. وَكَانَ وَعْدًا مَفْعُولًا, and it was a promise fulfilled. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this mischief that they caused on earth, and he mentioned thereafter they end by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending Nebuchadnezzar to go and overthrow them and remove them from the holy land of Palestine. Like we said, this marks the end of the Jews in Palestine 418 years from their establishment with Dawood alayhi salam up until they fall at the hands of Nebuchadnezzar in 586. 418 years. Only 40 years did this land witness Tawheed, did witness the oneness and the worship of Allah alone. The rest of the 338 years, idol worship, mischief, corruption. The Jews, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sunnah is from in this way that he leaves people for a time and thereafter their punishment comes. These people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, left them and sent reminder to them time and time again for 338 years, and thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala overthrew them. What's important to look at in this time is that after this period, when they are driven out of this land and taken as slaves and subjugated, it is only now that they decide now that they need to recall their religion. This is the beginnings of the Torah. 700 years after Musa alayhi salam, after the tablets were lost, before Samuel came, the Canaanites took their tablets, took their scriptures, took what they held as sacred and blessed. 700 years after that, after Musa alayhi salam, do they then decide to record their scripture? And logic will tell you it is impossible throughout these 700 years, with all the deviation and mischief and corruption, killing of prophets, all of these things, that the scripture could have remained in the hearts of men and that they were practicing it and following the constitution of Musa alayhi salam. It is impossible. So for 700 years, they had no scripture and now they decide to record it. When they find themselves now in the diaspora out of the land of Palestine, and for 400 years, man added and put in and removed and changed and decided what will be the religion of Judaism in the scripture that took 400 years until it came to book form and what's known as the Torah. We mentioned earlier that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they will cause mischief on earth twice. The first time, the commentators say that this ayah is referring to the mischief from the demise of Sulaiman alayhi salam till the fall and the complete removal of the children of Israel from Palestine. This is the first time that they cause mischief and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them those who will overpower them and remove them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them what they deserved. They were sold into slavery, their lands, everything that they held beloved to them was destroyed. When was the second time that they caused mischief, or when is the second time? We can see from history what they are doing now in Palestine, and maybe this is the second time that they are causing mischief on earth. Their current actions in Palestine, the killing and raping and plundering, what economic ties they hold with other countries, their social standings, what they are causing not only in Palestine but worldwide, this can be the second mischief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised that they will do on earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's promise will be fulfilled inshallah. We will see that Allah, like the first time, he will send to them servants powerful and mighty to overthrow them and to return the balance back to earth, and justice will be done upon them inshallah. We mentioned from the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about this event. What does the Talmud say? What do their books that comment on these events say? Their books that they hold sacred. What does this their book say about these events? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran curses them. And Allah curses them because of the knowledge they had. And with that knowledge, they still transgress. They still disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They still kill the prophets. They know well what is right from wrong. They know well what occurred in their history. They know well the prophets come to them as warners, but they still kill them. With that, they still cause corruption on earth. They are still mischievous on earth. They still disrespect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their scriptures and with their words. And they have knowledge of what is right and wrong, but with that, they disobey. They choose misguidance. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَبِمَا نَقْضِيم مِيثَاقَهُمْ لَعَنَّاهُمْ. Because of their breaking of the covenant, we have cursed them. Allah does not curse for no reason. Allah curses them because they know that they are breaking the covenant. They know what is in the covenant is the truth, but they still break it and they still disobey and they still cause mischief on earth. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curses them in the Quran, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has cursed these people. In the Talmud, it is said that they say that this event occurred the loss of this land and they being sold into slavery and being overthrown, it says, this happened when the transgression of the children of Israel reached its climax and they surpassed the capability of God. They say they surpassed the capability of God. This is not my words, this is in the Holy Scriptures. They surpassed the capability of God in bearing them and bearing their sins. And when they refused to listen to Jeremiah, when they refused to listen to they say a prophet Jeremiah came, they refused to listen to him. This is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them his servants to overthrow them. And this is not my words, this is their own words. So they know that they transgressed on earth. They know that they caused mischief. And with that, they still continue. Even in their books, they say Jeremiah addressed Nebuchadnezzar when these lands were taken and he told him, do not think that it is your power and might that has allowed you to overpower the chosen nation of God, meaning Bani Israel. Verily, it is their sins and transgression that has led them to this punishment. So even their prophet and their books say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them, but they still persist in their ways. That is what is strange about this nation. So after the fall of Bani Israel begins now the rule of the Babylonians in the Holy Land of Palestine. And this rule remained from 586 BC till 539 BC, only 47 years. Very different from all those that ruled before them. Only 47 years, it is as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only used them to remove Bani Israel from this land and for no other reason. For 47 years they ruled this land. And they were, like we said, from Al-Iraq, from the north of Al-Iraq or Iraq. And then thereafter, they were overthrown by the Persians. And we know in history that altercations always happen between Iran and Iraq, or the people that inhabited Iran and the people that inhabit Iraq throughout history up until the current day. And this is the way that these lands are ruled. A man known, or the ruler of the Persians at that time known as Quraysh, came and overthrew the Babylonians or Nebuchadnezzar. And thereafter, he established himself in this land. And he was helped by the Jews that he found in the Babylonian nation that was subjugated. He was helped in overthrowing them. And thereafter, he established Persian rule in Palestine, in the Holy Lands, and throughout these regions. And throughout those times, from the end of Sulaiman alayhi salam up until this Persian rule, throughout this time here, there is no Tawheed in the land of Palestine. There is only idol worship. Throughout the time of the Jews, then after the Babylonians, and now in the time of the Persians. And it remained like this in the time of the Persians for 207 years. The Persians ruled till 332 BC. Till 332 BC, and still no Tawheed has returned to this land. The Jews are living in the diaspora, some of them in this land, some of them in Iraq, but they are not together in one place, but under Persian rule up until this point. In the year 332 BC, Alexander comes about and he overthrows the Persians in this land and takes control of Palestine and parts of Egypt up until his empire even reached up until India, and he took control, Alexander, of Macedonia. This was now the time of the Greek rule, where the Greeks ruled. And there's something to allude to here. People sometimes ask the question or say that Alexander is Dhul Qarnayn, the one mentioned in the Quran, but that is not true, because Alexander, like we know, is an idol worshipper, and these ways of worshipping idols remained even in the time of Alexander. He did not do away with them, and Dhul Qarnayn was one who worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. He was a monotheist, so they are not the same person. But what concerns us now is that the Persian rule ended in Palestine and the Greek rule remained after that for 269 years, from 332 BC up until 63 BC. During this time of Greek rule, the Jews that lived in this land, Alexander did not subjugate them or treat them badly. He gave them freedom. But it was a time where there was lots of advancement. They saw the Greek Empire, they saw its advancement, so they assimilated. They learned the Greek language and they assimilated into Greek society in terms of culture, and even their religion changed. Two groups were formed of Jews in this time of the Greek rule. The first group was known as the Jews who assimilated completely. They learned the language, they learned the culture, and even in their books, what we find where they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this came from Greek culture and Greek belief. We find that they describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with terms which are not befitting No prophet could have said this. It could have not come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It came from these people. Until today, they still disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disrespect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like we mentioned in certain passages. They describe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in ways which are not befitting. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions it. He says that the Jew says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hand is tied. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ. This is from this time where they then started adding these things and fabricating and adulterating even more in their scriptures than before. The second group was a group that followed a man called Yehuda al-Maccabi, the Maccabee Jews. And they took him as a leader, and from him there was a certain protest and uprising, and the Greeks left them to protest and uprise, and thereafter they allowed them to enter Jerusalem on the 25th of January. And this was in the year 116 BC, and this is what the Jews celebrate as their day of celebration, or one of the days, as Hanukkah. Like we said, the Greeks ruled up until 63 BC, and then they were overthrown. Which nation overthrew them? What happened to the Jews after that? This nation that overthrew them then ruled for 700 years. What occurred in those 700 years? Isa alayhi salam was born in those 700 years. What was the story of Isa alayhi salam? Inshallah, you will learn this in the next lecture. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.